time.
Really
get over
day.
That old doubt, baby.
Oh, but it's cold outside.
The holidays are almost here, and apparently that means love will be in the air. We're talking about a phenomenon called cuffing season. It's a time covering the colder months where singles seem to fall into short-term relationships before then becoming single again for the summer and the better weather. So what is up with that, and is it okay? Is it a healthy practice? We're joined this morning by Dr. Gilda, who is a relationship expert, and she is going to explain this to us because, as I told you, Doctor, at first time I heard this terminology, I was a little bit nervous. I thought it was something strange, right?
Like
I don't know.
some kinky sexual
maybe
thing.
Yeah, but no. So cuffing season, just meaning we're gonna latch up as partners, right?
Well, cuff me because I'm freezing.
Okay,
so it's related to the weather.
To the winter weather. Okay.
Yes, and this is what happens. People get cold.
Yes.
Their testosterone rises.
Really?
Yes, in the cold weather.
Okay.
Testosterone rises, and as a result of that, they end up finding a mate.
Okay.
But often for the wrong reasons.
Oh, all right.
Because they're cold, and, you know, it dates back to the Neanderthal times, when people understood that weather and cold weather meant danger.
Yeah.
So what do you do?
Body
you get some loving.
Mm-hmm.
and once you can connect with somebody, you're fabulous
okay.
again.
But Dr. Gilda, now we have seat warmers in the car. I mean, this doesn't really seem necessary. Does it have a little bit to do with maybe all of the opportunities to take a date to a holiday party or kind of the loneliness that can come with not having somebody to spend the holidays with?
Sure. What is synonymous with freezing cold weather?
Mm-hmm.
Cold and lonely and dark and, oh my God, what am I going to do now? And I think I'll hibernate.
Okay.
So instead of that, we find somebody often too quickly and we end up connecting for a period of time.
Okay.
Now, there are problems with that.
What are those?
Well, first of all, are you connecting for the right reasons or the wrong reasons? Mm-hmm. Are you connecting because you're lonely? Mm-hmm. One of my clients recently said, oh, I married her because I was so lonely. And I said, is that a good enough reason? Well, a couple of years later, they were divorced.
Yeah.
So this is what happens. And we have to determine whether it's the cold weather that is making me want to connect, or whether it's really this person who's the love of my life and I really want to have him forever and ever and ever.
Well, and then in the other seasons, we see the reverse of that, right? Oh, friends are taking summer vacations or everybody's out at a pool party and there's lots of temptation around and maybe it doesn't seem so desirable to have somebody waiting for you at home.
And the person you were cuffing with suddenly gets dumped.
Right.
And
it's a roller coaster out there.
He or she doesn't understand and you don't even understand because you didn't know what you were all about to begin with. What was the motivation behind your connection?
So as we wrap up, what would maybe two questions be to ask yourself if you're thinking about taking a relationship to the next level? You've gone out with somebody and maybe you're considering being serious. How do you know that it's legit?
Well, am I interested in just feeling warmer and warmed by a warm body next
human.
To me?
Right. By any old human.
Or am I interested in this particular person because he or she is the love of my life?
Yes.
And this is a normal question for all of us to ask, whether it's the springtime, the summertime, or the wintertime.
Okay.
But be on your guard before you connect with whomever, why you are connecting with that person. That's why I wrote, I'm worth loving. Here's why.
I love it.
Because you have to know that you're super valuable and it's not just the cold weather.
Well, on that note, Dr. Gilda, thank you so much. Great book. Can we get that on your website?
Yes.
All right, we appreciate it. Good
thank
to see you.
You.
Stay warm, just maybe with a blanket. We'll be right back.